My brother, I knocked him out cold.
Man, shut up, dude.
Let's gamble it, bro. Dude, somebody please help me, bro. Dude, somebody please fucking help, fucking help, fucking help, fucking help, fucking help.
Austin Peterson, a.k.a. BossManJack, is a kick streamer, gambler, RuneScape PvPer, and master of the true shinobi gamer arts of not only living with your parents, but completely taking a hot piss on any sort of respect for such.
I wake up. I get breakfast fed to me. I get paid. I have no bills, no rent. I get to chill and just fucking not even work and just chill and gamble. Doesn't that sound nice?
Mom, shut the fuck up! Shut the fuck up, please! Please! You're a fucking idiot!
Dude, no one fucking just looked at it. Watch me lose every day, bro. 99% of my viewers. They pay for internet, electricity, utilities, but they can't support me at all. No bills. They pay for internet, electricity. No bills. Internet, electricity. Doesn't that sound nice?
No, it sounds very nice, Austin. It sounds great that you have utilized the support from not only your parents financially, but your own audience to constantly fuel your gambling addiction and self-destructive behavior. And then, as a full adult man-child that you are, instead of respecting, acknowledging, and attributing something to either your parents' household or the community who has financially supported your habit, tirades, and little fussy-wussies, you instead verbally abuse, berate, scam, and outright belittle anyone who doesn't monetarily support you in some capacity.
This rider guy has gifted dozens upon dozens of subs to these streamers, bro. Although this motherfucker's been in my streams for years and hadn't fucking subbed me once, man. Hasn't gifted me one sub. Get the fuck out of here, dog.
Surely somebody can help me, man. Surely somebody can help me, bro. Please. Can somebody please help me, man? Please. It's my birthday, man. This comes once a year, bro. And you guys are just sitting there watching me fucking lose. Whatever, man.
I just broke my... My dad is literally gonna kick me out. Shut the fuck up. You're a fucking prick.
Okay. Okay, there you go, unbanned. Welcome back to the chat, sir. Are you being serious, though? You're unbanned. I'm not gonna look at his chat log. I'm gonna give him another chance, even if he... Oh, he fucking accepted it, boys. Holy fucking shitballs. Wow. Is it a loan or is it a gift? A gifter. What do you want to do this as? Loan? Let's we'll make a loan, I guess. It's a loan, yeah, it's a loan. No, you won't. You won't. You won't, dude. I already fucking traded it, bro. He never said that even at the beginning either. He just traded it over to me. He's being a dickhead. It's a loan, yeah, it's a loan. It wasn't even supposed to be a loan either. He didn't even specify it was a loan or whatever. It's a loan, yeah, it's a loan. Go ahead, bro. Good, get me clipped. Yeah, get me clipped. I'm not even gonna pay him back anymore. Fuck that guy. He never even said I was alone anyways. It's a loan, yeah, it's a loan. Fuck you, dude. Don't fucking say you clip shit. I'm not giving you anything back. And you're getting banned again. And I'm putting you on my ignore list.
Now, there is a clip I will include where Austin emotionally addresses trolls slash haters who seem to maliciously enter his chat and bring up his past. So for those unaware, when Austin was 20, he was charged with grand larceny for a series of car break-ins. This led to trolls deep diving into how he was sentenced, causing some to bring up the fact that he was charged, and even others to maliciously say that he was some kind of snitch because the judge provided leniency towards him because of his age. Now, there is no evidence to suspect or to advise that he was a snitch or is a snitch. And when I show the clip, Austin does address this, which I'll go ahead and play now.
I fucking started stealing to support my habit, bro. I hung out with the wrong people, and karma bit me in my fucking ass. Karma bit me so hard in the ass, and I deserve every fucking bit of it, and I'm still not the same. I will never be the same again after I got fucking arrested. arrested for fucking stealing out of fucking cars, dude. Innocent people's fucking cars, bro. I am not like that, bro. At all, man. And these motherfuckers try to make me look like such a piece of shit, dude. I can actually break down, bro, but I think the medication I'm on doesn't even fully let me do it. I'm not fucking kidding with you guys, bro. I used to fully be able to fucking let my emotions pour out, but there's like something in my fucking brain now that wouldn't fucking let me, dude. I'm trying to tell y'all something, bro. Fuck all these motherfuckers that hate on me, bro. Yo, you guys are so fucking fucked, man. I swear to God, bro, you guys are the fakest motherfuckers I've ever seen in my life. We live in such a fucked up world, man, and you live to down others and to deceive others. Deceive others? Are you fucking kidding me? What is wrong?
Now, when I saw this clip, I can't lie, I really empathized for Austin here. I don't think someone should spend an eternity of their life constantly trying to justify the wrongs of their past. As long as they're trying to make attempts or trying to do their best to grow and develop and do better things or trying to be a better person. The part that kind of irks me, though, is that I feel like a lot of what he's addressing, the haters that he's addressing, aren't people who are just trying to drum up bits of his past when he was a felon to hit him over the head with it and make him feel bad about himself. While there is an exception to that rule, there are trolls who enter Austin's stream and who do spam the fact that he's a felon at him to make him feel bad. I think the majority of the clips that I've seen are just people comparing his current behaviors to the behaviors of his past and trying to show him that there's been no attempt for him to grow and to just not be a degen. In honesty, if Austin was truly appreciative of the platform he's been provided, of the home that has been provided to him by his parents, then the effort would clearly show over the years he's been on both Kick and Twitch. The writer clip, the one where he's talking about how this guy has been a part of his channel and has subscribed to all these other streamers but not him and he should just get the fuck out, that I actually showcased within this video, was actually fairly recent. It was within this week. And after reviewing the numerous clips and streams I've seen, it seems to just be a consistent pattern of use, beg, complain, destroy. And I don't think that's ever going to go away for Austin. In conclusion, this is my opinion. I don't think Austin will ever see this video. And if he does, my only goal is to showcase to him how even in the circus act that he's in, he could still avoid trying to be a clown. Maybe in some weird way, the criticism and opinion I could provide could be enlightening. But truly, I think he does need bigger help, and I do hope he finds it. I think maybe if Austin was on another platform that didn't incentivize his risk-it-all-to-win-it-all gambling addictive behavior, then he might be able to have a chance to grow or better himself. That's to say, I just think what I see is just someone who's more than likely will always be the way he is, and he'll always be around, just to suck on the underside of whatever teat they can till it's all shriveled up and they move on to the next. Anyway, this is my opinion. This is my video. Thanks for stopping by or whatever. See ya. Bye.